My name is Praveen Sutram. I'm the president of Next Services. In this video, you're going to learn how to use the PPP Loan Forgiveness Calculator.
It has four components. One, the maximum loan amount that you can get. On this sheet, as you can see, you can enter the salaries of your employees and then be able to compute the maximum loan amount that you can finally get. I'll walk you through it. Second, the forgiveness amount by headcount. Now, as you know, the PPP program allows for loan forgiveness up to 100%. So in this calculation, I'm going to show you the forgiveness amount after headcount reduction and the final payable loan that you will have when you bring back your employees if you had furloughed them. Third, I'm going to show you the forgiveness amount by wage reduction. In case you're taking salary cuts or you've done salary cuts for your employees, I'm going to show you what that implies in terms of loan forgiveness. I've called it a loan forgiveness penalty. So doing all this, you will be able to finally arrive at one, the maximum possible loan for you. And then once you receive the loan, how much penalty you would be paying or the loan that you would be repaying by changes in your headcount or by changes in wage reduction to arrive at a total forgiveness amount. So let us get started. Before we begin, I want you to understand that this calculator is only for estimation purposes and for educational purposes. Before you make any business decisions, I would advise that you contact your accountant or lawyer. I just want to also walk you through on how Google spreadsheets work. So here, the controls are at the bottom. You see the different sheets at the bottom and you click on them and you would be able to navigate. When you click on these arrows, you scroll right or scroll left, and that way you'll be able to get to whichever spreadsheet that you're interested in. Now the loan forgiveness calculator for computing the maximum loan amount. Enter the all the different employees that you have in your practice and estimate the gross salary that includes all the benefits in this column. Like, so for example, I have employee number 3 at $50,000. I might have employee number 10 at $70,000. And then I have two employees here who earn more than $100,000. One is at $150,000, the other is at $175,000. So now while your total payroll may be 1.4 million, you can't use this in case of the loan amount calculation. So for the loan amount calculation, what this calculator does is it caps any employees who are over $100,000 to $100,000. So as you can see, it does nothing to the ones that are below 100, but 150 gets converted to 100K, 175 to also 100K. So you can do this. So if, say for example, I make this into 250, it still caps it to 100K. Then once you do that, the total for this example is a little over one million. And you compute the monthly payroll from that by dividing this by 12. And what the maximum loan amount is you multiply your monthly allowable amount into 2.5. So here we arrive at $225,000 for this practice. Now let me show you how to calculate the forgiveness amount or the amount that you don't have to return after taking the loan when there are variations in your headcount. So let's look at this. To clarify, the covered period for this loan is 8 weeks, meaning once you take the loan, you're expected to completely spend the amount within an 8-week period from the loan origination date. Now in this calculator, you can enter the loan origination date here in this cell and it automatically computes a loan end date. For example, if you have a loan origination date of May 5th instead of May 1st that I have taken, the loan end date changes automatically. I have assumed that this practice got a loan approval for $200,000 and received that amount. Before the covered period, the practice had 20 full-time employees. There are two options to compute this. I've listed it on this cell. Then during the covered period, I've divided it into first 4 weeks and the next 4 weeks. So let's assume that you had furloughed your employees, but then and the number that you had during the first 4 weeks of the loan period was 12. So this is the average number of full-time employees for each pay period falling within a month. That's what they're looking for. And during the next 4 weeks, you had 18. You know, that was the average payroll or headcount that you maintained. The average of both these numbers is 15. And then the way to calculate the forgiveness amount is 15 divided by 20 multiplied by your loan amount or the loan that you received. And when you do that, you get $150,000 in this example. Let me show you the calculation. 15 divided by 20 into 200,000. And then naturally, the loan, you know, when $150,000 is forgiven, the amount that remains is $50,000. So this is the amount that you have to pay back. Now, let's look at the forgiveness amount when you reduce wages for employees. Now, in this practice, again, there are 20 employees, two of them, and all are on W-2. Two of them earn more than $100,000, and 18 of them earn below $100,000. So I would enter the last full quarter that you have paid, meaning if for most of the practices, it would be Jan, Feb, and March of 2020. So enter the full salary for, say, employee number one that you paid during the months of Jan, Feb, and March. Divide that by three, so you arrive at a monthly average salary that you paid out. And then once you do that, what the calculator does for you is it removes the employees whose salary was over $100,000. Like, so as you can see, if this number amounts to greater than $100,000, what the rule says is, even if on a given month the effective annualized salary is over $100,000, then you can't include that employee for this forgiveness calculation. So we remove that, and then you can enter the percentage of salary reduction that you want to do. In this case, I've said 15, but I'll revert it back to 20%, and I have various numbers. So let's say for employees 10 to 12, I'm going to do a 30% reduction for some reason. So as you can see, my numbers keep changing. So the other columns are, so this column describes the new monthly salary after you reduce. This is just for your reference. But what you actually need is the monthly salary that you actually reduced. And so this depends on the percentage. What the rule allows for in order to get 100% forgiveness is a maximum cut of 25%. So what I've done here is I've estimated 25% of all salaries. So this employee number one had a monthly salary of $4,167. So when I do a 25% of that, I get $1,041.67. All right. And again, as you can see, I've removed for employees number 19 and 20 because they make more than $100,000. Now, how do you compute the forgiveness penalty amount? When I call this a penalty amount, what I mean is this is the amount that you have to pay back. You've taken a loan This is the portion that is not forgiven, and then you have to pay back. So this amount comes into picture whenever your monthly salary reduction exceeds 25%. So just very simply put, if you take this example of the employees 10, 11 and 12, so we did a cut, more than 25%, that is 30%. So the reduction was 1750. The 25% comes to 1458. So the amount, the forgiveness penalty would be $291 and change. So when you add all these numbers up, you finally arrive at a total loan forgiveness penalty. In this example, it is $4,375. And again, to remind you, in the example that we took, you received a loan of $200,000. When you remove the amount that you have to pay back, you finally arrive at a forgiveness amount after wage reduction of $195,000, $625. Let's move to the final sheet. So this is the loan summary. So this ties all the other computations together. The maximum loan possible in this example was $225,000. The start date of the loan was May 1st. The calculator computes the end date for you. Then you enter the actual loan received. And the calculator pulls in the numbers from the other areas or the other spreadsheets where you've computed the loan forgiveness penalty by headcount. In this case, $50,000, it is coming from this spreadsheet, here, this number here. And in case of the wage reduction, here's less forgiveness penalty by wage reduction, it's 4,375, that is coming from this spreadsheet, from this cell here. And that's how you finally arrive at a total forgiveness amount. You're simply subtracting the loan that you received, and you're taking out the penalty amounts of $50,000 and the wage reduction that you have done. And then you arrive at a final forgiveness penalty, or the loan amount that you actually have to pay back on this loan that you've taken. Thank you so much, and we wish you all the best through this phase. Bye.